Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to today's edition of Programming Wizards. Today we shall look at something quite interesting. We shall look at TreeView. Okay? Now, this is what we're going to see. First, we shall look at how to populate a TreeView dynamically. Okay? Yeah, as you can see, on button click, we can populate our TreeView. And then I take note that when I click a node, you can see I can capture that particular event. Okay? For instance, Man United. If I click Man City, so this way you can apply to your code the way you like. You can, for instance, Bundesliga. You can see how we can populate and capture the on-click events, the after selects events for the TreeView. Now we can also clear it and repopulate it again. Okay, so guys, this is what we're going to look at. Welcome. We get first thing first. Create your project. I've already created mine. Now here is my form. I'll just resize it a little bit. Then add your controls, add a TreeView, and add two buttons. Now here is my TreeView. This is a TreeView by the I've called it TreeView 1. This is my populate button. Now when the populate button is clicked, we shall populate our TreeView. And then when the clear button is clicked, we shall clear our TreeView. Now that's it. So just double click your populate button, and then also your clear button, and lastly double click your TreeView. Now if you take note that if you double click the TreeView, it shall bring to this TreeView 1 after select. We shall handle this after TreeView dot after select event. Okay, so actually what we shall be doing here, we shall simply display a message. So if you had something to do, this is the place that you can do it. When the thing is clicked, you can capture, you can do it right here. Now, very first, the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to populate our TreeView when the populate button is clicked. So we shall have to define that populate button, that populate method or procedure, populate our TreeView. And to do that one, come and say a private sub populate. That's it. Now, the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to create a variable. I'll call it node. Not exactly a variable. We're going to create a tree node object. Okay. So, as node, that's the first thing. We create our tree node object. Then after creating our tree node object, we're going to create our topmost. Remember, this is a TreeView. There are different level of the nodes. Now our topmost node, we are going to assign it to this node object. So say node TreeView 1 dot nodes dot add. We're going to add, in fact, we're going to add our topmost node. Okay, remember we've created this tree node object known as node. So the first thing, inside our TreeView, we're going to add the topmost object. So we pass the name right there. Now for mine, I'll just call it soccer leagues. This one shall be my topmost node, the root node, I mean. Okay, now after adding it over there, we shall come now and add our first level, because this is the root node. Now we shall have several levels. Now this is the first level. I'll just give it section A to help explain better. So say TreeView 1 TreeView 1 dot nodes. Now this one shall return for us a collection. We pick the very first collection node. Okay, then after picking it, say dot nodes, then we add the title for that particular node. Now this is the first level. For me, I'll give it Premier League. Then after giving it Premier League, what we're going to do, we're now going to in fact first level section A. So we're going to move to the second level section A. No, this is a comment. Second level section A. Now to do that one, let's come and say TreeView 1. Now for our second level section A, come and say TreeView 1 dot nodes. Now once more, this one shall also return for us a collection. I will pick the first level in that collection, then again nodes, then again the first level, then dot nodes, then is when we add. Now for this one, the first one, I'll add the team manually. Now what I'll do now, we shall copy paste this one and re-add it, because remember this is the second level section A. Okay, so it's just the same level. Let me remove or let me change this one to Chelsea or something. Okay, so this is our second level section A. Now this next thing that we're going to do, we shall come to our second level section B. Second level section B. Now to do that one, it's simple. What we're going to do, in fact, before we come to our second level section B, we shall need to come to first level section B. I was just forgetting. So have there first level section B, and what we're going to do, just come copy paste this one. It's going to be at the same level as this one right here, and then I'll change now this one to La Liga. Okay, now after that one, our second level, the same second level section B. Now what we're going to do, we're simply also going to copy paste these ones and change the just come copy paste this one this way and change. Make sure you change this one to 1. Okay, this one was level 0, now we are in the level 1. This is the second level section B. Now probably let's add the third level, first level section C. Now for our first level section C, I'll change this one to Bundesliga. This is the German league. Now after that one, we're also going to just copy paste these ones here. Let me just comment it first. No, this one now shall be a second level section C. Then we come over there, we paste. Okay, now take note, this one we've moved from 1 to 2, then from 0 to 1 to 2. Okay, so this is the second level section C. In fact, to make it clearer, let me just come here, section C. This is section C, then this is section B. Then of course this is section A, and that's it guys. Now if we come and run, let's run first before we handle the after select events. Now if I click populate, you can see it has already populated our stuff very nicely, our TreeView. But now take note that if I select, nothing happens. What we want is that if we select, we want probably to handle that selection event. Now for that one, let's come right here to our TreeView after select, and just come say message box dot show, and what we're going to pass there is actually what we want to display here is to just display what has been selected, the text display selected text. Okay, well here if I comment clear TreeView, now to display selected text come and say TreeView 1 dot selected node. Now we have to get selected node first, then we get the text property for that particular node, and that's how we display it. And then if we want to clear, we'll have to say TreeView 1, okay, TreeView 1 dot nodes, TreeView 1 dot nodes. We want to clear all the nodes dot clear, and that's it. Now we can run our simple program and see. So guys, I come click populate, it gets populated. Now if I click Premier League, you can see, if I click select one of the team, you can see we can handle the selection events, the after select events, and display the appropriate text. If I click clear, it gets cleared. If I click populate, it gets populated. So guys, hope you've learned something, hope you've enjoyed the tutorial. Please, if you've subscribed to this channel, leave a comment down below, share this video with friends, and please take care. See you next time.